In the last video, I did an early morning tune around the HF bands, going from 200 kHz up to 30 MHz. This time, I'm at the beach, doing it the other end of the day. It's about 25 past 8, just around sunset, and I'll be here tuning for about the next 40 minutes or so. This time, I'll start higher up around 30 MHz and tune down to below 2 MHz.
Just start from above 30 MHz. Not supposed to listen to them, so we'll just tune quickly. These are old style cordless phones. We'll just go to AM and tune quickly, as I don't think there'll be much up here. This is the 10 meter band. No SSB activity. Beacons, most Australian beacons are 28.26 to 28.27. I thought I heard something before. Didn't get the call sign, but that's in Brisbane. So it's a VK4 beacon. Little bit of sporadic E. Pretty weak. CW end. Now we're into the marine part of 27 MHz. Not heavily used. Most people now use VHF marine. Now we'll keep tuning, and now we're into the 27 meg CB band. Most people use lower sideband. This is where the step tuning of the FT8 ones. This is channel 35, lower sideband, most popular. Bit of AM still. Bit of not a lot of use in of this part of the spectrum. There is an amateur band, 12 meters, down around here. Nobody there. almost need an electric drill. We are heading into a low sunspot period of the cycle. So these frequencies shouldn't see much use, although you'll still sometimes get activity from our near north of Southeast Asia. Here, we're approaching the 13 metre broadcast band.
Naskah asli dalam bahasa Arab berjudul Al-Iman Ar-Rusul Alayhim Salam. Disusun oleh Marwan Hasan Hamad.
Sound like some Indonesian. Modifikasi. 15 meter amateur band. It's a radio that I'm testing.
Oh, cool.
So we're just getting stations from all over the world. Activity on 15 metres. The sun has just set and it's 20 to 9 local time. This is Beacon. International Beacon program frequency. Beacons all around the world are on here. That last one was, I think, VK6RBP in Perth, about 2,000 kilometres across the water from here. Again, a part of the spectrum, we don't hear many signals.
Para அவங்களும் பண்ண கருதா நம்ப
This location is slightly different to where I listened in the morning a couple of days ago, only about 500 meters away, but I think it's a little bit quieter. That's lower sideband. Lower sideband is not very common.
The Taliban Purandi Jagra Bonbas Talatkiap.
Well, an isolated station. Usually you hear other stations around, but not in this case. Just coming up to the 17 meter amateur band.
Oh,
The 17 metre broadcast band.
You may hear, does one find and or play hockey? That's the larger question.
I don't see a lot of ice rinks, though. I just don't. Anyway, thank you very much, Bridget. It's 51 minutes past the hour. Let's get into what's happening in the world of entertainment on this with me. Minnie.
Thank you, Paul. The Queen of Hell, Aretha Franklin.
Thank you. Катер попадает в аварию. Йонг падает с него, а катер добирается до конца улицы и разворачивается.
Now we're coming up to the 20 metre amateur band, though one thing I'm noticing is there's quite a few shortwave broadcast stations outside the normal shortwave broadcast bands.
Thank you. Send your answer to the following email address, kai@cri.com.cn. You can also log on to
Okay. UTC on the 11th and 1002.
This is the 25 metre broadcast band, one of the most useful and active shortwave bands. There's usually stations on it, all except the middle few hours of the day and the depths of night.
International siaran bahasa Indonesia yang dibacakan oleh Nasir.
Mixture of upper sideband and lower sideband here. Shows that HF radio is still very popular. Now we're approaching the 30 meter amateur band and fortunately some radar. Thank you. WWV. Now we're coming up to the 31 metre broadcast band, another one that is very popular, particularly around dusk and evening. What are you out to? It's a shortwave radio, so we're picking up stations from all over the world.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that legal?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Is that your aerial?
Yeah, the aerial's just on a fishing pole. So, yeah, it's just a bit of wire.
And what are they saying from the other side of the world?
Oh, all this stuff you can't understand, but other stuff that's Morse code.
Your research or something?
Oh, no, it's just a hobby.
Yeah.
I do a lot of YouTube stuff, so a lot of people like watching you know, how the sound, how it sounds like from the other side of the world.
Yeah, that's interesting. Yeah, I'll see you now and then. I was going to ask you one day, but it's interesting.
Yeah, I do transmitting as well for ham radio, so okay. Sometimes, yeah. Talk around Australia or around the world.
Oh, really? Oh, alright. Answer that question. Oh, enjoy your night.
Oh, have a good night.
See ya.
Yeah.
The 41 meter broadcast band, mainly good at night, but if you're near broadcast stations, it will also propagate quite well during the day, up to about 1,000 or so kilometres. And here, we're in the 40 metre amateur band, where we should hear some DX stations.
That's the amplifier right off, and I can see that the needle's going right back to zero, so I think it's probably coming from the...
Seems to be no CW activity on 40. Chirpy CW. Not a very quiet spot for this part of the spectrum. The 6 MHz band is quite good for short to medium distances, and it used to be very heavily used in Europe. Some of the European radios had a special shortwave band covering 6 MHz over an expanded part of the dial. Now this is around the 60 metre broadcast band, 5.1. It's a very strong fax service, I believe. WWV. Usually at this time, this band, a 60 meter band, would have a lot of signals, but not so good tonight. Tune quickly, as we've only got a few minutes left on the camera. Down here's the 80 meter amateur band. The Sydney Beacon. Down here, broadcast band, 90 meter band, I think. Just tune quickly. Maybe see Northern Territory used to be down here. Now we'll tune 160 metres amateur band. Not much on 160 metres.
Yeah, he's cool.
planes to four.
Lots of jokes.
I think that is. Also,
if you have a
see that.
Four. That they can.
Third.
Give the planes.
This has been a tune around the HF bands. It's a good idea to do it every now and then because I find a lot of amateurs are stuck on only what's in the amateur bands with little awareness of frequencies either side. It's also good to do it at different times of the day and from different locations because what you hear will vary.